folks, Dagan here from PMTVUK, and this isn't just any Line 6 DL4 Mk II. This is a limited edition 25th anniversary silver Line 6 DL4 Mk II. And to celebrate, not only do you get a snazzy new colour, you also get a little DL4 keyring. Now, if you're unfamiliar with what a Line 6 DL4 is, either the original or this snazzy Mk II, in this case the silver one, it's a delay pedal. The original ones came out in 1999, hence the 25th anniversary model. You can see a picture of one right there. You've probably seen one before because they're bloody iconic. Used on some of the most important guitar tracks of all time. The DL4 was at the infancy of guitar modeling, and this was the first kind of pedal where you could like pick a specific effect, like a delay in this case, and go between tape delays and analog delays and modulated delays and all that kind of jazz, but they absolutely nailed it with the tones as well. It was a lot of people's first ever dive into hearing in person what a tape delay sounded like. They made them for years, everybody loved them, and they had a revamp a few years ago, and they added some more delays. So there's 30 delays in the Mk IIs, the regular 15, and a new 15 taken from Line 6's Helix and HX range of effects. So there's 30 now, and it's awesome, and like I said, to celebrate 25 years, you can now get it in silver. And of course with the lovely keyring. What also made these pedals incredibly important when they came out was the fact that you could go between different presets, different saved delay presets. And those pedals that kind of did this, but Line 6, like I say, absolutely nailed it with the design and the execution. I forgot I clicked on the funky delay. Well, one of the many funky delays. In the DL4. Such a great pedal. So yeah, the presets were a big deal, but also the fact that it was incredibly easy to use to get these to get these incredible iconic delay sounds, they made it so simple. Simple. Control. Select a control on the left here, what delay sound you want. Tweak the time, the repeats, the tweak and the tweeze, alter the different parameters within that effect. So if it's like a modulated delay, you can alter the rate and the depth of the modulation and stuff, or tape in that and mix at the end. Tap tempo function down the bottom there as well. And another awesome feature of the original is the fact that it had a built-in looper. This does as well, and of course the anniversary one does too. Super easy to use as well, got the play, stop and repeats and all that jazz, the record and overdubs at the bottom there. Incredible thing. These new Mk IIs though have a mic input. The originals were used heavily by, I'm gonna say like experimental artists that wanted to really layer and loop and delay their vocals. So to make things easier, instead of getting a fancy cable, XLR to quarter inch jack, there's an XLR cable on the input on the top right there with its own independent gain control. Next to that expression pedal input. Get expression pedals, mix between different delays, change parameters and stuff with an expression pedal if you want to do it that way. Totally runs on MIDI. It's got a micro USB slot on the top as well, so you can save your loops you've recorded with your DL4 Mk II, or I guess download other ones to the SD card and plug it in the back right there. That's kind of all the specs, I guess. Let's hear it some more. It's running in the effects loop of the Black Star St. James, and talking about the selector switch before, notice some of the types of delay are in white, some are in green. The green are the legacy. So the 15, tap this down, the light goes green. That means you're controlling the legacy effects. So those are the 15 effects that were in the original Line 6 DL4. Let's have a play with some of the effects now. Let's go. That's the worst thing about delays when you make a mistake. You have to listen to that same mistake again and again. It's a right pain in the ass. So a lot of the green ones are like the original. Is the delays we're all accustomed to, I guess? But with the Mark II having all the delays, the extra 15 to make it overall 30 delays from the HX range, with the alt switch not lit up green, you get the inner types of delays. And that's where you get all those lovely modern HX effects. This is glitch. Someone way more musical than me will have so much fun with this and write Grammy winning records. I can't do that. Anyways, some of them are cool because they're like rhythmic. And some of them are cool because they're pitchy. Yeah, stuff like that. But you, obviously they are the regular harmony. It's quite good. I played some Brian May in the intro. Why can't I just use this instead? Good old duck delay. Now, if you don't know what a duck delay is, essentially that's a delay which only kind of raises its head when it realizes you're not playing, so it doesn't get too messy when you... So when you're playing your note, like your crazy runs and stuff, you don't get inundated with all the delay repeats, so it doesn't get too messy. It knows when you stop playing and... only raise his head right at the end. Let's hear some clean tones now. Thank you. think, ladies and gents, that's all the sight specs and sounds I can give you from the wonderful 25th anniversary limited edition. You only get one 25th anniversary Line 6 DL4 MkII delay. Let us know what you think down below in the comments, and like I say, if you want to get one for yourself, there's a link in the description box down below which will take you to pmtonline.co.uk. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up and hit subscribe. You'll find us at Play Music Today on all social media platforms. I've been Dagan, I'll see you next time.